My name is Clarence Lee Sherrill, S-H-I-R-R-E-L-L. And I've been around a long time.
Now, the name of your business here is?
Concrete Casting.
How long have you been doing this?
Well, since about 7 o'clock this morning. I started in about 53, doing it in my basement at night. And I worked for a family business, ready-mix business, and I'd take the products home to the plant and sell them, and it grew to the point that I no longer take care of it. I sold it to the family business and I went ahead with my work there, but I lost out in 1980. So in about 82, I started all over on my own full time then after that. And I've been doing it ever since. I started out in Chaffee, but people were very nice down there, but there was a lot of the same people always passed by. Up here, we've got new people passing all the time. Had a person in Sunday that from Wisconsin that bought a statue and left it here but paid for it, and they're coming back next Sunday, which is Easter Sunday, and I told them I wouldn't be here, but they're going to pick it up and take it back to Wisconsin with them.
Do you consider yourself an artist?
No, sir. Just a hard-working man that's willing to, that takes a lot of pride in my work.
You know, when someone asks you what you do, what do you tell them?
Very little. I try to take rough and kind of crude concrete and make it to the point where it's an attractive piece of concrete that people would want to have in their yard. I don't do any of the painting. Krista does all the painting. I get it ready for the painting. I don't work fast enough that I keep up all the time, so Krista has to help me with that too, quite often. We don't paint near everything. The bad part of paint job is sooner or later it has to be repainted. It fades or it peels, or it looks far better whenever it's first painted, but it looks bad whenever it needs painting. And we repaint for people quite often.
Do the painted pieces sell better?
Some people like one, some like the other.
Yeah, I tend to go for the natural look myself.
Well, my wife does too. And I'm about as natural as you can get.
Yeah. Now, how did you and Krista get together?
Well, she may have to answer that. She was in high school and came and asked me for a job, as I recall, and hired her. And except for maybe 4 or 5 years that she was in another job, she's been working here. Very happy to have her.
About how long has she been with you?
You're about 30 now? Have I given bad information yet? Well, she would have been probably 16 when she started working, and she's 30 now.
Like the work?
Yeah, it is.
Looks like it'd be fun.
It is. Always something different.
Yeah, Krista is willing to do whatever we have to do. We pick up heavy pieces of concrete, and she picks up the... She takes the heaviest end. Well, I've been around a lot longer than she has, but she's very, very strong, very willing to do the job, very happy with her. No relation whatsoever, but we get along just fine.
So if you guys have been here maybe working 8 hours a day, what, 5 or 6 days a week? Or
5 for Krista, 7 for me.
And she's been here for the last 15 years or so. Do you remember about what year you all ran out of something to talk about?
No, I don't recall it.
I'm curious, can you purchase your casts, or do you have to make them, or both?
I used to pour everything, bought molds, and poured our everything here, but you were so much more limited. Price of molds went up a lot, and more wholesalers become available to me, and it's cheaper for me to buy it because of the price of the mold. If I bought this cow mold and it didn't sell very good, I'm hung. I bought two the other day, and I've sold one.
So these come to you already formed up?
And I go to them.
Well, you have to go get them.
I want to pick out what I want. I pick out each piece, and I buy from about 10 different suppliers in probably 5 different states, and bring in a load at a time, and each time I go back, most of them have another load of something else new that I can pick out.
Well, how do you decide what you think is going to sell or be? I mean, you picked a cow here, it's a good looking cow, but I mean, is it just a guess?
Educated guess. Kind of on past history, what has sold or what people come in looking for. We have lots of people that ask us to try to find them a certain piece of concrete, and many times we never find what they want or just what they want. People often say, well, I like that cow, but could you get it a little smaller? Well, what they're saying, it's more than I want to pay. That's where
you hide. You could just tell them to put it further away in the yard, it'll look smaller.
Well, or if it's too big to suit them, I say, well, just dig a hole and put it in the ground a little bit.
Did you ever pick a piece that you thought to yourself, this is going to sell, this is going to be popular, and it just didn't move?
More than once.
Any come to mind?
Well, we got a cowboy and a cow and an Indian out there that's about
to sell. I saw that as
time.
I came in, yeah.
Have them sold the first one. And I didn't think we could keep them in.
Hope you didn't buy a lot of them.
No. I bought several because I was just sure that, but not to the point where it's going to break me. And someone will be in, and we'll make, you can sell a little bit of almost anything.
Now, is there a graveyard where the ones that just do not sell and you got to make room, that you put them out in the back 40 or something?
Never have had to do that.